Hi, I'm Max from WeVideo, and for today's episode of Tuesday Tips and Tricks, we're going over animation. Specifically, how do we create the animation that you just saw? This topic came as a suggestion from our previous episode of Tuesday Tips and Tricks, so I encourage you all to continue to provide your feedback as it serves as a guide for our future content going forward. With that, let's get started. The intro to our Tuesday Tips and Tricks video was made using quite a few video tracks. To start, we began by creating our icons in an image editing software like Canva or Photoshop. Then we exported each of them as a separate PNG file with a transparent background. Then we imported them into WeVideo. From here, we mapped out the order we wanted each item to appear and dragged them onto separate tracks. In the preview screen, we laid out all of the images and the design we wanted the final result to look like. The first item to be animated is on the bottom track, and the last is on the top. After everything was laid out the way we liked, we cut each of the clips into two parts. The first part is the half-second animation, and the second part is the time it stays stagnant after the animation has ended. We used two types of animation in our intro, an animated slide and an animated scaling. The first animation in our sequence was the picture of me that slides in from the right. To animate it, we double-clicked the clip, opening up the Clip Editor menu, and then selected the animation icon. Next, we simply clicked the start arrow and then positioned the image off-screen. One thing to keep in mind is that since we wanted the clip to slide into frame perfectly horizontally, we made sure that the beginning and end Y coordinates were exactly the same. The end of the animation is already set from how we positioned it earlier, so we simply selected Save Changes, and now that animation was set and good to go. The scaling animation for Tuesday Tips and Tricks icon has a pretty similar setup. Start by clicking the clip and opening up the editor and then selecting the start button. This time, instead of moving the image out of frame, we moved the scale slider to the left so that the size is at 0.01. Then we added a super quick fade in by selecting the fade box at the bottom of the menu. This makes the animation look like it's appearing from nowhere. Repeat the process for each clip and you've got yourself an awesome intro. Our clips are all stacked in a staggered layout like an upward staircase. This is because we didn't want all of the animation to happen at the same time. Since this is a time-consuming process, we recommend saving this as a project that you can reuse as a template for multiple videos, just like we have. That's a wrap. Thanks for viewing. And if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please leave them in the comments box below. Till next time, bye.